talk. Let the money talk till
I keep hearing things.
Must be the money talk. Let the money talk till
I keep hearing things.
Must be the money talk. Let the money talk till
it must be the money talk.
Let the money talk till
it must be the money talk.
Let the money talk.
2015, podcast number 4, Steve Stevens in the motherfucking house. With my best friend, my number one gun, the Big Skipper. What's going on, Skip?
Just steering the ship, partner.
Oh, my God. I'm glad to be back, man. Another day, another dollar, huh?
You know it.
God, man, it feels good finally to get rid of the holidays, get back on the grind, and actually put some numbers up on the fucking board, huh?
Feels real good. My pockets are getting real deep.
I'm hearing things.
Oh, I've been hearing a lot of things, Stevens.
Yeah, we're going to get to that in a minute, Skipper.
Some of this shit is crazy.
Well, it's something that we're going to have to address right away because I got to get some things off my chest. You know, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the podcast. As you know, the Skipper and I give it to you the real. We talk about sports. We talk about entertainment. We talk about what's hot, what's not. We give you inside information to Las Vegas, show you how to win games in a way that you've never, seen or done before in your entire life. But today, I'm just going to talk some shit. I'm going to get a few things off my chest so America can get straightened out on a few different issues of what's going on. We got a few things that we've been hearing, and at the end of the day, we need some fucking answers, Skip. What do you think?
Well, we don't want to sound like we're whining. We don't want to sound like we're crying. We don't want anybody to feel sorry for us, because believe me, we got very good lives. And there's just a couple of things that we've been hearing around the neighborhoods, and it's actually kind of entertaining, to be honest with you.
Well, I mean, it's just fucking hilarious. Ladies and gentlemen, listen to this podcast and listen to it fucking close. Everybody and their mom thinks they're a handicapper, okay? I'm going to answer a lot of questions for you guys today that I've never answered for you before. Because we're getting ready to film Money Talks on a brand new network, our TV show, here next month. So we've been sworn to secrecy with not answering questions about season one. But there's certain shit I just got to get off my chest. You know, Skip, I know you've been hearing a lot of shit as well. You want to read a couple of the questions over there on the list about, what people are asking?
Well, people are asking, when's the next show? When's the next season coming out? Where's Pirelli?
Hold on. Let's address them one at a time. Well, Money Talks will not be out probably for 6 to 7 months. You will not see even an advertisement for it till about June or July. We won't even start filming until the end of next month. And in about 3 weeks, I'll be able to tell you what network in the whole nine yards. What was the next question?
People have been calling in asking if Pirelli's around. They haven't seen him or heard much of him.
All right. Well, here's the deal with Chris Pirelli, ladies and gentlemen. Chris Pirelli, when he came to work for me, he lived in the apartment complex right behind my office over here.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, guy was driving a Honda Accord, wearing the same pair of jeans every fucking day, whole nine yards.
Oh, you talking about these one-bedroom apartments back here?
Yeah, right back here, the Daily Budget Suites over here.
Oh, boy. Yeah. Nothing wrong with the hood.
Not at all.
We're from the streets, but not a place I'd be living.
No, absolutely. Came out here to Las Vegas. Nobody knew him. He was going to the Palms every night, pipping a dirty hole, which is no big deal. I love him. I took the kid under my wing. I loved him. So I brought him into my business, took him under my wing, show him how to sell sports a little bit. At the end of the day, I put him on a TV show, made him out to be like some great salesman and somebody who he wasn't. Now he's running around Las Vegas like he's fucking a superstar and wasn't producing any money. So I had literally bad-mouthed him so much for not making money. I mean, Skipper, what were you pulling in a month during these months? When we were airing the TV show, were you pulling in anything less than 100 grand a month?
That wasn't 1 or 2 months. I had like 80 or 90, but we did quite well, sir.
No, what was he pulling in? $700 checks?
There was a period of times where he was pulling in $700 checks. He was partying a little too much.
He was more worried about going out saying, hey, my boss's show. Hey, you want to fuck up?
Not showing up for work.
And Paula were more worried about getting side deals and acting like superstars. See, anyone in Hollywood who wants to be in Hollywood, you'll never get there. See, me, I don't give a dog fuck about Hollywood. You understand that? Anyway, took him under my wing, made him some money. See, I am the most connected motherfucker that you know. Floyd Mayweather's a friend of mine. They were doing a show. Floyd had nothing to do with my show. We got together with the producers, Todd Kreitz, Jackson Wynn. I had a show done about my entire life. I've always been the number one sports consultant room for the last 10 years, writing 50, 60,000. So, I bring people over here in my room. I take them under my wing. I create advertise. I get people to call. I just saw Pirelli the other day. He was wearing the same pair of True Religion jeans I bought him and the same BMW I bought.
Oh, boy.
Motherfuckers forget that I'm the one that created the leads, that $250 new you sold that I upgraded for $200,000. Yeah, I did that. So just to set the record straight, Pirelli does not work here. He doesn't know a fucking thing about sports. He's not that good of a salesman. He was making $500 a week. I put him on a TV show. His head blew the fuck up. And that's pretty much the end of Pirelli. The guys like him come a dime a fucking dozen. I got 40 guys that replace him. I got 10 guys that replaced him the next day. But, you know, he's a two-faced motherfucker. He's a guy that doesn't give a fuck about me. But back to my point. Here's a guy that knows nothing about sports, but now he's running around town like he's a sports consultant.
Well, these guys set up in their basement. They set up in these one-bedroom apartments. I mean, they're using their cousin's attic.
He must have forgot Paula hated that motherfucker. I had to beg Paula to move her, you know, allow him to move in. And we'll get to you next, Paula. You're next, sweetheart.
It's been an interesting couple of months, I'll say that.
Oh, yeah. It's been a very interesting month. So, Pirelli as a person, love him to death. One of the dumbest motherfucking businessmen in the fucking world. Put him on TV, blew him up, was getting ready to make him money, take him to the next level. And he just believed that he was the TV character that I made him, rather than in reality that, you know, he lives in Paula's third room making fucking $800 a week. Off to Paula. Paula, actually it says on the paperwork, does Stifler's mom still work here? Stifler's mom that you're referring to is Paula. And no, Stifler's mom was fired for embezzling VIP sports.
Ouch.
Paula was caught writing electronic checks to herself on top of getting paychecks and robbing me blind.
Oh, boy.
Correct. She robbed me for the amount of like $30,000,
$40,000. Oh, brother.
Straight embezzlement, you dirty bitch. I've known her for years, too. So, you know what? I'm from the streets. I'm thugged out. I figured, you know what? I'm going to leave the bitch alone. I'm not going to pull no civil suit on her. She already has enough problems as it is. She's already living in that house that I put on my TV show she lived in. She's got five roommates. They got the real world living out that motherfucker. Like, you know, 15 people in one house to pay the rent. And just found out from her ex-husband, Dave, that, you know, Paula's going after more alimony. So he's going to go ahead and sell that house that you're basically just renting over there, Paula. You're broke as fuck. You got no money. You rent a house. Stop acting like you're celebrities. And that's what I want to get off their chest. I'm not trying to pump my own dick. But I'm the one that created all this shit. I'm the one that's making millions of dollars. I'm a true millionaire from sports. I come from nothing. I'm the one that has a room of 20 guys doing $20,000 to $30,000 in business a day. We do between $150,000 and $200,000 a day. That's me. I pick winners. I bet $50,000 a game. Guys that were my own friends like these Pirellis and Paulas, these motherfuckers don't know a fucking thing about sports, don't know anything about sales, don't know nothing about nothing. But these are the same type of people that ruin the industry.
Boss, you've been nothing but good to me, and let me just come in here right and interject.
Did you hear about these motherfuckers trying to open a sports room?
That's what the talk on the street is. It's actually hilarious. I mean, you know, you've been nothing but good for me, nothing but good to me and my family. And for people that you've helped out and to turn their back and to do things like this, it's just, it's actually mind-boggling.
Well, Paula, I portrayed her as making millions of dollars on the show. Paula was on a $1,000 a week salary.
It's unbelievable.
Yeah, Paula was robbing my company, making $1,000. Chris Pirelli, whatever $100,000 he made that year, was I upgraded all his paperwork. I mean, I just took Pirelli to a concert the other night. But for him to run around town and acting like he's a handicapper, ladies and gentlemen, Chris Pirelli doesn't know a fucking thing about sports. He doesn't know shit. Paula doesn't know shit. None of these guys know anything.
So when you guys were at the concert, he didn't say anything to you about he's going to start his own service?
Nah, man, I could always tell that him and Paula were two-faced, thinking that they could do what I can do. They could set up a room. I could give them the keys to my office. They wouldn't be able to do shit. These motherfuckers got a room making no money. So they're completely irrelevant. I'm not even worried about that. What I want to let ladies and gentlemen know is that I'm getting sick and fucking tired. The reason why I brought them up is an example. How many people, Skipper, are claiming to be everybody and their mom's a fucking handicapper? Who are these people supposed to believe? I mean, I'm so sick and tired of you guys dealing with these fucking companies. Everybody that has a website is not real. Everybody wants to be like us. These people aren't licensed and bonded with the state of Nevada. These guys don't have a 30-man sales force pounding out 20 news a day, writing $150,000 a week. These guys are all full of shit, Skip. Why don't you tell America the difference between us and these other fake buster motherfuckers?
Well, the difference is we've been at the same location for 12 years, the same phone numbers. You got a multi-million dollar network set up, not just here in Las Vegas, but all around the country. We talk to CEOs. We talk to beat writers. We talk to scouts. We talk to retired players.
Last time I checked, we deal with the biggest elite sports bettors in the fucking world. If anybody says they have bigger players or a bigger database or higher-end clients than us, they're lying.
There's a lot of imitators out there, and like I've said before, in order to imitate success, someone's got to be successful. The fact of the matter is...
It doesn't piss you off these people are believing these fucking busters? Like, what happens when Pirelli and Paula actually make calls? There's going to be idiots out there that believe them. They know what they're doing.
What bothers me is that these people are out there throwing darts with other people's money, and these guys are legitimate players. They want to win. They think they're getting into the right information. Little do they know, they got people like you've just mentioned set up in their basement or in their garage.
Been in the business for what, 2 years?
Throwing darts with their money. I mean, it gives our industry a bad name. It gives a guy like me and you. We have an uphill battle to fight because of people like this, and there's a lot of fakes all out there, and that's just the way it is.
Just because you look at statistics and think you're a handicapper doesn't make you a sports consultant. Don't you understand that we've been doing raw sales for 25 years? If you want a guy that's been in the business for 25 years, I've been doing this shit day in, day out, 20 plus years. I'm willing to die for this shit. I'm not some young punk that just got in the industry. I'm third generation, born and raised in Las Vegas. I deal with players, coaches, CEOs. I deal with the guys that make the line, and I win more games than any other motherfucker in the world. And by the way, you want to win games, call 877-220-6540. Get the play of the day. We're in a good mood, so call today and we'll get you on a special little week of service.
VIPSportsLasVegas.com. That's how you can get a hold of us. Forget all the riffraff. Forget all the guys throwing darts with your money. And go to VIPSportsLasVegas.com. Is there anything else you want to get off your chest?
No, that's pretty much it. And like I said, Pirelli, I love you. Paula, you're a fucking thief. You guys will never make a dollar. I'm just finally had to answer some questions for my fans that really wanted to know. Yeah, the bitch really robbed me. Yeah, Pirelli didn't make no money. Yeah, he left because he was making $400 a week, and he couldn't make a dollar anywhere. The only reason why these people got any shine is because I'm a star, I'm a millionaire, I came up from the streets, I've earned my respect, and I've earned every motherfucking dollar I got. So the difference between me and these other fake motherfuckers is I've earned my stripes. I come up in these fucking streets. I've earned every fucking dollar. I don't lie and I don't fucking cheat. Yeah, I've been to prison. Yeah, I've been shot. That was 20 fucking years ago. Get the fuck over it. For you millions of people that love us, though, Skip, we love you. How about you love these motherfuckers?
I love them. I love you. You love me.
Listen, so we just addressed the fucking 12, 15 backstabbing fucking people. There's about 10 haters on the internet. Those are our only haters. On a positive note to you people that love us and have our back that are making millions of dollars with us and the 800,000 people that email us looking for the new show and follow our podcast, thank you.
My son thanks you. My wife thanks you. And on a positive note, yes, my family is here and I'm happier than ever.
Yes, sir. For you guys that didn't know, the big skipper did make the move, didn't you, Skip?
I'm here. I'm here to stay. The wife is here, which is a beautiful thing. I'm back to getting laid again.
Well, I mean, not to mention, $800,000 for a short year, 5 hours a day. Not too bad, huh, Skip?
Well, we won't talk about that.
But my point is, you know, I'm just trying to keep it real with people. You know, you didn't make $10 million fucking dollars this year. You didn't make $100 million. I mean, 800 fucking grand.
Yeah,
I mean,
yeah, but the wife thinks I only made 200.
I'll make sure I delete that. But here's the deal, guys. I have 30 fucking salesmen dedicated to providing the best sports information available. Nobody does what I do. No one has a company that does what I do. I keep getting prank calls from this guy, the Philly faggot. Claims himself to be a godfather, a Philly fucking faggot. The guy, I pulled him up on the internet, looks like he has Down syndrome. The guy's in a room with about 4 or 5 guys writing about 5-10 grand a week, acting like you're me. Listen, motherfucker, you're nothing like me, little dick. You're broke. You don't have any client base. You don't make fucking $100,000 a week. And you drive a Honda Accord pitching out of a fucking one-bedroom apartment.
You're a minnow.
You're a fucking sweat on my nuts. Get off my nuts and tell your bitch to come here, would you?
You're like a 2-inch dick out of hip-hop porno. There's no need for you. No.
Oh, my God. Skipper Brato. You're like a 3-inch dick out of hip-hop porno. We ain't got no use for you, motherfucker.
Oh, boy.
Oh, my God. Look at little dicks. For those of you that are in my industry, all 10 of you, listen, there's guys in our industry that do it right.
Oh, there are.
You know, a couple good guys that actually do it the right way. God bless you guys that do it the right way. For you 10 haters who want to be me, Get off my dick, please. I come from the streets, man. I've earned every fucking million that I've got twice over. You got to have talent to make money. They don't just give it to you. And I'm also tired of these little, what's this guy's name? Famous Dave? Famous Dave's Ribs, the guy that's Paula sucking his dick to get the leads for Fred and Paula over at their new room. You shouldn't have sucked his dick, Paula. He's only 5'2". He was trying to get to me anyway. He didn't want to fuck you. He wanted to fuck me.
Oh, pinky dick.
He saw the show. He wanted to get to me and make fucking money. Hey, Famous Dave, you don't have a fucking clue about this business, little dick. There's a difference between trust fund boys. See, there's a difference between guys, trust fund guys that are rich that think they can bet, and guys like myself that got rich from betting.
Oh, sugar tits.
Big fucking difference. So listen, Famous Dave, little guy, and all you little fucking munchkins out there, you got to learn how to sell. Without a sales room, see, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to end it like this. Everyone thinks they're handicappers. None of them have sales room. Without a 20-man sales force grinding the phones all day, generating new business, there is no winning for nobody. You could have all the winning games in the world if you have no one to give them to. What do they mean, Skip?
They don't mean a damn thing.
So back to the people that want to hear us. I just wanted to get that off my chest, clear that up. You'll never hear those people's names ever again. Like I said, Steve Stevens, the real deal. Real multimillionaire, real entrepreneur, number one sports consultant in the world. And at the end of the day, I love my fans. So let's get back to talking some shit. Skipper, what the fuck do you think about that LA-Cleveland game tonight, pal?
Well, I don't get intrigued too often about the NBA, but LeBron James in LA tonight against Kobe. Kobe's actually going to get in the game tonight. He from the information that we've gathered, he's going to play, and he's going to rest tomorrow because they got to play Utah tomorrow on the road. You know, the Lakers have been home since January 6th. I mean, they've 10 days without any travel. You know, if you paid attention to the podcast the other day, I talked about Cleveland after they lost to...
Oh, hold on. Absolute blowout winner on your pick, Skipper.
Yeah, after they lost to... Cleveland lost to the Sixers last week, I said they were going on a West Coast road trip and they were in big trouble. Well, sure enough, they haven't won a game since I said that.
Period.
They're 1-9 against the spread their last 10 games. Absolutely horrible.
I think it's a shit game, Skip. I know you're intrigued by it, but, you know, of course we're not betting it.
Let me tell you what intrigues me about the game.
Are you leading? Is this your free play, Skip? Are you leading to this might be your free play? Is that what you're leading to here?
Well, I can give you an opinion based upon what I'm gathering.
Well, they know they're not my plays. They know that none of my – we don't give any of the plays I sell for free. None of my clients ain't got to get worried. None of that shit.
It's an intriguing game because the Lakers have actually covered 11 out of their last 18 games. I mean, they're 8-2-1 against the spread. I'm sorry, 11-5-2 against the spread the last 18. On the other hand, like I said, the Cavaliers have only covered one game against the number in their last 10. They've been out on the road. They're tired. They're banged up. The Lakers are at home. They should be fresh. This is their last home game. They've been in L.A. for 10 days, as I said, without any travel. However, you know.
Like that joint, please. Skip's boring me.
However, they are the second worst team in the West. I mean, the only team that has a worse record than them is Minnesota.
Oh, absolutely.
So, you know what intrigues me the most about the game is the total. 12 out of the last 15 Cavalier games have stayed under the total. 12 out of the last 15, okay, including 7 out of the last 8. Now, the Lakers, on the other hand, 8-2-1 to the under. Their last 6 games have been under the number. Now, listen to what I'm telling you. The Lakers, 6 straight unders, okay? The Cavaliers, 12-3 last 15 to the under. This would lead you to believe on paper that the game should probably stay under, given the fact that, you know, the Cavaliers are pretty tired from being on their West Coast trip.
Is this leading to believe that your free play today is going to be the under in Cleveland, Skip?
The line has moved 3.5 points to the over. The money's actually coming in on the over. This is what intrigues me about this game.
Well, I can tell you what, it don't intrigue me at all. As much as I love you and love hearing you talk, dude, when you just talk about Cleveland, period, right now, it just makes me sick. I was about to go to sleep. Thank God I had some good marijuana.
Well, you're ranting and raving about Pirelli and Paula and about all the haters, and I'm over here.
Well, no, it's just the guys in our industry. People need to understand that not everybody does what we do. There's nobody out there that does what we do, fucking period. Here's the bottom line, guys. If you want a motherfucker that's willing to go to war for you, I'm the guy. If you're going to go to war with a bookie and you already have an Uzi, couldn't you use a tank? All I need is 1% of your trust and confidence. I guarantee you, as a businessman as well as a gentleman, I'll earn the other 99%. There comes a time where you deserve to shine, ladies and gentlemen, and that time is fucking now. So I'm not going to sit here and let these other motherfucker imposers get on the fucking phone, telephone tough guys, act like they're millionaires, act like they're pitching in penthouses, acting like they got money when these are broke, dick little motherfuckers.
Man, I can tell you just took a couple hits off that joint.
And I'm feeling good. Whew. But I'm telling you right now,
you are
I'm the real
fire.
Well, I'm the real fucking deal. My mouthpiece is a fucking weapon. If you don't have any sales talent, if you're not willing to go out there and get the fucking job done, if you're not willing to paint your face and go to war, get the fuck out of the industry. And I'm telling, I'm putting an APB out right now for every motherfucking sports service out there. If you think you're hard or you think you got something on me, you let me know. You come to my office. 4004 shift drive. At the end of the day, nobody's better than us. All you guys do is talk shit because you know you're not better than us. So bow down to somebody greater than you. Nobody does what we do. Nobody fights the way we do. No one deals with players, coaches, CEOs. So for you little fake motherfucking frauds out there with an internet, taking a picture in front of Las Vegas, claiming to be a big willy, claiming to be a millionaire when you're living in your mom's fucking basement, wearing a pair of dirty ass fucking stinky shoes with a fucking Celtic tank top, the fuck out of here before you get the shit slapped out of
you. You want some water, dude?
Fucked up, huh?
You all right, man?
No, man. I'm just tired. I had to get... Listen, that's 1 year's worth of money talks.
Man.
My fans deserved that. My fans been fucking begging me. And
you got You got some pent-up aggression there.
You know what, though? Because I always had love for Paula. I'm from the streets. I'm a gangster.
I know. Listen, I know it hurts, brother.
I always had love for her.
I'm around you every day.
And I always love Pirelli. And I know they fucked me, dude.
Listen, I know you love Pirelli like a little brother.
Yeah.
I know you love Paula like a
sister. So, you know.
And for them to turn their backs on you and pull this kind of shit.
Bullshit.
It's insane.
So, you know, I owed that to America. I'm over it. I love you guys. That's the real deal. But me and Skip are going to be coming live and direct every single day, 4 days a week doing a podcast. What do we got for him today, Skip?
Back to the NBA, the Cavaliers at the Lakers tonight. Tomorrow night they got to play the Clippers, so they'll be staying in L.A.
Are we clarifying that the play for these people are the under?
No, I'm gonna actually go with the Lakers plus the points, plus the six at home.
Ladies and gentlemen, Skipper's free play. Opinionated play, opinion only, it's not the games for sale, is the L.A. Lakers plus six. Give it to them again, Skip.
I'm going to tell you why I'm making an educated guess on
please, that. Please.
The Cavaliers are 1-9 against the spread the last time.
Guys, listen up. Hold on. Listen, guys. We don't just give you the games that we threw a dart at. Skip, give them a fucking breakdown of why you want to play the game, whether it wins or loses.
I'm going to tell you why I'm taking the home team in L.A. tonight plus the six. The Cavaliers are 1-9 against the spread their last 10 games. On the flip side of that, the Lakers are 11-5-2 against the spread their last 18. The Lakers have been at home. They've been rested. They've been in L.A. since January 6th, 10 days without getting on an airplane or traveling. And Cleveland's been out on the road on a West Coast trip, and I think they're getting tired. They haven't won a game in 100 years, and they got to play the Clippers tomorrow. LeBron James was at the championship game. Kudos to Ohio State. Shout out. They did the
all
job.
Day.
How about that, Cardale Jones?
Oh, 12-gauge, baby. 12-gauge.
Oh, my God.
Hey,
unbelievable.
Listen. Yeah, well, that's pretty much how it is. They're fucking phenomenal.
So I'm going to take the rested team at home, even though they're absolutely horrible. They got the second worst record in the Western Conference. I'm going to go with the Lakers. I'm going to go with Kobe to maybe show up tonight, take the 6 points. And I'm thinking that the Cavaliers might be partying a little too much on this West Coast trip out in L.A.
I love it. Skipper, let's get back to work. And I want to give a live shout-out to my office, everyone at my crew, all 18 guys. Great job. We broke a record today, as you know, Skip.
It was a big day.
31 fucking news in one day. We haven't done that in a while. Anybody in our industry, you guys are out there struggling to get, what, 2 news in a day?
Basketball. Hockey, college hoops.
You got
the easiest money you've ever seen.
Easiest money in the fucking
VIP
world.
VIPSportsLasVegas.com. VIPSportsLasVegas.com. There's a game tomorrow night in the NBA that I love a lot more than this Laker game. I don't love the Laker game. It's just an opinion. Lakers plus six.
Hey.
So tomorrow, there's a game that Steve has information on in the NBA that will absolutely get us the money. We're waiting for all the chips to come down in the right place, and we're positive we're going to the winner's circle. VIPSportsLasVegas.com. Give us a call. And we'll make sure you're on that game in the NBA.
I love you guys. I summed up some questions for you. We'll get back on the positive shit. Remember, we're the best. Fuck the rest. Love you. Good night.
Peace out.